Hi, this is Camille from Nuts and Bolts Speed Training, and in this video, I'm going to show you 13 free PowerPoint templates that are worth checking out online today. Before I walk you through each one of these 13 free PowerPoint templates slide by slide, I want to issue you a very quick warning. Most of the free templates that you find floating around on the web, and there are a ton of them, are not worth your time. Why? Because they are poorly built and constructed from the get-go. That's why I combed the web to find this list of the highest quality templates that I could possibly find for you to download. Now, why are most of the PowerPoint templates out there poorly built? Well, they are actually built more as a collection of slides that are built in the normal view that look pretty, you know, when they're finally finished, but that they're not actually built solidly on top of a blueprint, which is the slide master view that is normally used to build a PowerPoint template from scratch properly. So let me show you exactly what I mean. In this template, you'll notice that the slides look very nice. You know, if I go down, page down, slide by slide, it looks very attractive. However, one thing to notice is if you go to layout, you'll notice that each one of these slides is built on the title slide layout. And this comes from the slide master view. So if I go into view and slide master, you'll notice that the Slide Master is essentially the same default one that you get just when you open up PowerPoint. And so there's nothing that's been customized here. And so when you go here into the normal view, then the layout, every single slide is using this title slide layout. So for example, if you hit reset, you're going to get these placeholders that pop up because this slide was actually just built with individual shapes, lines, and text boxes that aren't using the actual layout of the template the way it was designed to be built. And this is problematic because it means that if you make any small adjustment, for example, if you inadvertently adjust this, right, or you move, you know, this line by accident, you move it over to the side, you're going to have to spend all this time manually trying to adjust it. Is that right? You know, is this right? Readjusting everything to make sure that it fits. Whereas normally, let's just say here, you know, you accidentally nudge this slightly up, and you nudge this one slightly down, you tweak this just a tiny bit. If I go into full screen mode now, that if I go from slide to slide, you'll notice that the title is actually going to jump. Now in this situation, because it's animated, it's not so obvious, but if you have a presentation that's not animated, you're gonna see these titles bouncing around and it's gonna look very unprofessional. Normally what you would do is you would simply hit reset and the title, because it's tied to the slide master, would jump back to the position where it needs to be, but because this was not built using these placeholders, the title and none of the content on this slide actually readjust. So you're stuck doing it all manually yourself and you'll end up with something that looks pretty terrible and unprofessional. If you want your template to be built properly from scratch, I recommend either purchasing one online from a reputable source. You can find more information about that in the notes for this video down below, or building one from scratch yourself. When you get something for free, it will always be relatively lower quality and you will be stuck with whatever the issues are that are built into the template itself. But there are a few free PowerPoint templates that you can find that are high quality. And those are two of the ones listed in this list, the Bubbler and the Origami templates, which are 100% functional as complete templates. The other templates in this list are basically as close as you can get to a perfect PowerPoint template that is free online. So I've done my best to find the best PowerPoint templates out there that are just as close as possible to being a 100% perfect template. And that's why I'm going to show them for you today. When would you consider using some of these templates? Well, if you want to use a fake PowerPoint template, one like I demonstrated for you, or one that's built 90% close to where it needs to be, you can absolutely do that. It's a great way to, for example, jumpstart your slide building process, so you can use these slides as inspiration for creating your own templates or your own presentations. You can use them to create a one-off presentation. You know, maybe you're just doing a presentation that's going to be displayed only once and doesn't need to be copy and pasted to other presentations, then you can go ahead and use one of these templates as long as you're aware of some of the pitfalls of them. Or if you're quickly creating a single slide that you want to insert into another presentation, then you can try and copy and paste some of the content in the normal view of that slide over into your own presentation. Free PowerPoint template number one, the Bubbler template by Showeet.com. Now, I love this template. It is my number one rated PowerPoint template for this entire list because it is properly built in the Slide Master. And I'll show you that in a second. But first, let me give you a quick overview. If you go to the slide sort of view, you'll notice the theme of this presentation. It uses a very consistent color scheme, and we have these sort of bubble design elements that are carried along throughout the presentation, which I find very nice and quite fun and engaging. The Bubbler template includes 23 pre-built slide layouts along with 3 additional slides that give you information for the credits and copyrights for the images and other elements in this template. Otherwise, you have 23 beautifully built PowerPoint slides. What I love about this template, among other things, is that it is built correctly in the Slide Master view. So if you go to layout here, you'll notice that these layouts are built correctly and attributed properly when used here in the normal view. And if I go to the Slide Master view, you'll see that they are built correctly based off of this parent layout here that is emulated here throughout the child layouts. And that means that it's going to be built properly when you copy and paste slides in to and for this presentation, this template. They should come in relatively correctly. The other thing I love about this template is the color scheme. You can't see it here in the list of color palettes, but if you go and insert, for example, a new shape, and you go to pick one of these colors, you get some really nice color options, and all of these colors are low in saturation, which means they will look very nice on almost all projectors that you find. And so that is a really nice plus if you're going to go ahead and use this color scheme. The other nice thing about Bubbler being built correctly on the template and using the theme is that if you did want to go ahead and change the color scheme, if you just adjusted it, you'll notice everything adjusts along with you. And so that means that it makes it very easy for you to just quickly change the color palette to something that you would prefer using. And that will make everything so much easier for you down the road. Notice how everything adjusts except the logo, which is fine because that is just a picture. It looks like even parts of the logo might have adjusted because these might be vectors. So everything adjusts, which is just such a help for anyone who's building presentations because it can take so much time. And if you have to do everything manually, it is such a big waste of time. That is why I like the Bubbler template as one of the best free PowerPoint templates that I can find on the web. Now, how do you use this template? Well, it's very easy. You simply go ahead and make any adjustment to the title of the template. Just type in any words. Go ahead and make any changes that you want to this. You can also adjust the date by going into the header and footer dialog box here and by changing the content here, applying to all if you want it to apply it across your presentation. And for anything that includes some instructions, like here, click to add a picture. If you click on this, you can open up anywhere on your computer where you have images saved, and you can actually go ahead and insert images directly onto the slide. And you can do so in any of the places that has one of these little icons. You can go ahead and add anything that you like, and it will be cropped to fit this exact shape the way that the placeholder determines that it's going to fit. Some of these already have a picture in it, but if you want to change that picture, you can simply go to picture format and you can change a picture from a file or from the web, or you can also change it into an icon, or you can go ahead and delete this and then you'll get the placeholder back and you can insert a picture as well. Now, if you have this folder open, what you can do simply is drag a picture directly over here and you'll notice the icon changes to this little plus, which means the picture will be inserted into that placeholder. And again, the reason that the placeholders are so important is because if you make any adjustments, you accidentally warp it, you do something strange to it, you can simply go to the Home tab, hit Reset, and it will reset into that placeholder perfectly the way it was supposed to be. And the same is true for all of these in the rest of this template. Anytime you see a placeholder. These are charts, so you would edit this the way you would edit any normal chart. This is a table. This is a piece of smart art. So again, you would edit it just the way you would edit any normal piece of smart art. And this is a picture. So again, you would edit it as a picture. Or if you have your own map, you can go ahead and insert that map, and maybe that breaks up into individual pieces that you can color the way that you like to color them. That is how, in a nutshell, you would begin to use this template, and it is very easy to use when it's built correctly. free PowerPoint template number 2, the Origami template by Showeet.com. And this template, I would say, is tied with the number 1, the Bubbler, also built by Showeet.com. And the reason it is one of my favorite free PowerPoint templates on the web is that it is built correctly in the Slide Master. You'll notice that these layouts here are all using the correct layout in the Slide Master. They're not all just built on a blank layout here. So if you adjust something like this, you know, the templates will move back exactly where they're supposed to be. Same for if you make any changes to this, you change the, you know, the font by accident, whatever it is, if you hit reset, the title will reset and everything will look the way it's supposed to. So that is one of my favorite, most important things that I look for in every single PowerPoint template that I evaluate. If you go into the slide sorter view, you'll notice that this template includes 28 pre-built slides. It also has 3 slides at the very end thanking you and telling you where to go for credits for the photography and other elements in this template. And you'll also notice what's fun about this template is it has a sort of origami theme to it. Each one of these slides continues the theme. You'll notice here we have an agenda slide. We actually have 2 agenda slides. We have a couple options for transition slides that each have this origami pattern with it. And that makes the template consistent and coherent throughout it. You can choose to have a very big element of origami or a smaller one here around the slide title, which I think is quite cute. So this means that the template will stay consistent and coherent, and that's always nice because it feels like every slide is a part of the same template. Now, the other thing that's great about this template, just like for the Bubbler, is if you change the color scheme, you'll notice that everything adjusts accordingly. So if I change this all to blue, everything will adjust, and it means that you have to spend a lot less time changing things manually yourself, and that is always a wonderful thing when you spend so much time building presentations like we all do. One thing to note about this presentation is that it uses Calibri font, which should be included in your version of PowerPoint, and you also have the option to download the 16:9 version of the presentation template or the standard 4:3 version. So that is the Origami template by Showeet. How would you use this PowerPoint template? Well, just like for the Bubbler template, you could go ahead and make any changes to the text here, any changes to the color, the font, anything that you like, the way you would normally edit a PowerPoint presentation. And you'll notice that there are some pictures here. If you go ahead and delete that picture, a placeholder pops up, which gives you an opportunity to insert your very own pictures into this template, and they should all paste in correctly. In this situation, you may need to make some adjustments, for example, send to back, and that will adjust everything so that it looks the way it was designed to look in the template. And the same would go for any other picture that you see here. You can go ahead and delete it, or if you see a picture placeholder, I'm not sure there's one in this presentation, these all include images, but if you ever were to see a placeholder, you could go ahead and delete that, any image here, and add your own just the way that we've described previously. Free PowerPoint template number 3, the corporate template, also by Showeet.com. I really like this template because I like its boxy feel. It is indeed quite a corporate sort of a style of template. Again, because it's built by Showeet, it is also almost 100% built correctly on the Slide Master. But first, let me walk you through what the slides look like. If I go to the slide sorter view, you can see that this template includes 30 pre-designed slide layouts, and you'll notice there are a bunch of examples of transition slides. We have a coffee break slide, some basic slides with title and text, a big image slide, some data slides, along with a lot of other examples, along with a thank you slide, and 3 slides giving you credit information for this template. Now, you'll notice these slides actually look empty, but in reality, if we go back to the normal view, these are not just rectangles, they are actually placeholders to insert a picture. So if I click on this and I insert a picture, it will populate in the right place. You can adjust, you can flip the picture horizontal if you want to adjust it, and then you can hit reset to make it go back the way that it should go. Each one of these slides, especially the ones that look empty, are actually not empty. They are a place for you to insert pictures. And of course, once you do this, you may want to go back and hit reset, and you may even want to send this picture to the back to make sure that all the elements populate in the correct order and that everything is visible here in the normal view. So most of these layouts here, you'll notice this one, even though it's cropped like this, the picture will be inserted correctly. So for example, if we insert this clock, it will be cropped to this shape size that is determined by the placeholder. So all these transition slide examples are basically variations on the same theme, and you can again insert a picture here in, let's just say this one, you can insert a picture here in the placeholder. So this is how you would go ahead and use the template using the slide master layouts that set up the placeholders, which allow you to insert pictures and have them populate correctly. You'll notice this one very nicely has some cutouts in it, so it looks quite stylish. And if you go ahead and send it to the back, everything will populate. And I really enjoy this nice gradient here that allows the image to peek through but makes the text still visible on top of it. So again, this is a beautiful template. It is, I would say, 90% of the way there, maybe 95% of the way there. And I will show you what I mean here in a minute. Insert a picture. We also have a nice map, but it's actually an image, not an actual map that you can break apart. So if you have your own map graphic, you may want to insert it here. The one area that is not 100% built correctly on the Slide Master is that the parent layout here is not exactly set to match what the default content layouts are going to look like. The title is formatted in a certain way, and if I go to the parent layout, it does not exactly match. So that is one small area, and you can learn more about what this means in the blog post that I have in the description of this YouTube video down below to see exactly what this means for using this free PowerPoint template. One final thing I like about this template is I like the color scheme. I think it is nice and simple and modern, and it stands out very nicely. The thing to keep in mind is that some of these colors are a little bit highly saturated, especially this orange. So if you're using an old school projector, or if you're not 100% sure what projector you're using, this color may come out and be really, really bright and garish. So I would recommend potentially switching over to a different color palette, or potentially just adjusting some of those highly saturated colors. You can pick some of these, but again, you want to make sure that these aren't super saturated. Some of these is hard to know until you start manipulating it yourself. But here are some examples of other colors you can use. And because the template was built properly, the colors all translate nicely over here in PowerPoint. You may need to adjust some text here, and you could do that in the Slide Master view. All right, so now you've seen the top three free PowerPoint templates from around the web. But don't go yet. There are 10 more awesome templates for us to look at. In the next video, I'll show you the next best ones, starting with a clean and professional corporate template pack. So stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like, thumbs up down below, leave a comment, and make sure to subscribe to our channel with the notification turned on to find out when we release our next awesome PowerPoint tutorial. Thanks, and I'll see you at Happy Hour.